Hey guys, I'm Andrew Flushi, your Virginia traffic and misdemeanor defense attorney, and this video is going to talk about checking the dates on calibration paperwork. The most important thing in most CAT cases, other than our first video that we just talked about how to make sure this document actually applies to your case, you got to check to make sure the dates fit within the statutory range. So in this document, we're hoping to zoom in on the final video. You'll see it says this is a tuning fork certificate like we talked about in the previous video in this playlist. And then you'll see it talks about the date the test was conducted. In this case, the test was conducted on June 3rd, 2015. So you gotta look for that date of when the actual test was conducted. Here's the key thing on dates. There's two dates on most of these certificates. One is the date the test was done, and that's the most important date. The other date on this one on the back, there's actually two different dates. It shows the dates that people signed it. These are gonna be important in the next video we're gonna talk about. And those are basically certifying that this document is a true copy. But those aren't important for the date. What's important for the date is to make sure that the actual test on the equipment was performed within the 6 months leading up to your ticket date. So let me repeat that. You gotta look at your ticket date, what date you received the violation, and then count back 6 months from that date, and then the date the actual test on the officer's equipment was done needs to be within that 6 month window. Okay, so you count back 6 months from the date of the offense, and the date on the paperwork for the test, the day the test was done, needs to be done in the 6 months leading up to that. That's the key here. I've had officers, I've had in cases an officer will have a certificate that was done after the stop, but before court. So maybe they wrote some tickets, they realized, oh, my paperwork's out of calibration. So they went and got it done. And they try to bring it to court and say, well, it can be 6 months either side. It's good for 6 months. That's not the question. The question is, at the time they wrote the ticket, when you allegedly broke the law and maybe committed a crime, allegedly, can they prove that on that day they knew their equipment was working? Can they prove it? And that's what they need to have the certificate for, and it has to be within that 6 month window. Now, maybe not every judge would rule that way, but I've had that exact issue in many of the courts around the Fredericksburg, Spotsylvania, Stafford area, and the judges routinely will say it needs to be 6 months before the incident, not just any time 6 months before or after. Because this is trying to prove that on the day of the incident, they knew their equipment was working and we can rely on it. And so it needs to be within that 6 month window. So for this video, that's the key issue, is look for the date the test was conducted and make sure it's valid. So to check out to the next issue, be sure to click on this playlist and you can view the next issue, which is whether or not this copy is a valid copy. So be sure to check out the playlist and keep learning more about tuning fork and radar and LIDAR calibrations.